Example number 1. If a line intersects sides AB and AC of a triangle ABC at D and E respectively and is parallel to BC, prove that AD by AB is equal to AE by AC. So here they given the figure. So first you draw the figure along with the given points. As per given point in triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC. Now applying the theorem BPT, that is basic proportionality theorem. So by BPT here we will get AD by DB equal to AE by EC. Okay, so in bracket you write it here by BPT. BPT means basic proportionality theorem. Now what we need? We need AD by AB, but we getting here AD by DB. Here also AE by AC we want, but here we getting AE by EC. So in figure we getting only part of that whole side, but in proof we need total AB. So for that what we have to do? First you reciprocal the AD by DB and AE by EC. So by reciprocaling here we will get DB by AD equal to EC by AE. Why I did reciprocaling? Because here DB we need AB, but we getting here DB. For DB how much we have to add? We have to add AD. So if you write DB in the denominator we can't add, that's why I made it into reciprocal. So in numerator we can add easily any part. So here AD is there, here AE is there. So what I will do, I will add one on both sides. So it will be DB by AD plus 1 equal to EC by AE again plus 1. So now taking the LCM here, it becomes DB plus AD whole divided by AD equal to EC plus AE whole divided by AE. Now you see DB plus AD in figure, DB plus AD. So if you add these two you will get totally AB. So right here AB by AD. Similarly EC plus AE, EC plus AE, what we getting? Total side, that is AC. So here it is AC by AE. Now again repeating the reciprocaling, so AB by AD I will write as AD by AB equal to here also AE by AC. We will get what we need here, we got it. Okay, see here in proof AD by AB, AD by AB, AE by AC, AE by AC. Okay, so here write it as a proof. Okay, so like this we have to use the basic proportionality theorem in finding the parts of a side of triangle.
Exercise 2.2. In first question they given two diagrams. In first diagram they mention that DE is parallel to BC in triangle ABC. We have to find the measurement of EC, where they given the sides AD, that is 1.5 cm, DB is 3 cm, AE is 1 cm. So already we know DE is parallel to BC. By applying basic proportionality theorem by BPT, we will get here sides ratio, that is AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. Okay. So now substitute the values. AD is 1.5. DB is 3 cm. AE they given 1 cm. And EC we don't know. Keep like that only. So now do the cross multiplication. Take EC to your left side. And 1.5 goes to right side, it becomes division, and 3 becomes numerator of the next term, that is 3 pi, see like this. 3 will goes upper side and EC comes upper side. So EC equal to 3 by 1.5. Here you can directly divide these two, or else first make them into whole numbers. So multiply the denominator and numerators by 10 by 10. Here we get 3 tens are 30 divided by 1.5 into 10, you get here 15. Okay, so 15 ones are 15, 2s are EC equal to 2 cm. We got here EC equal to 2 cm. Similarly, in the second diagram also, they given in triangle ABC. DE is parallel to BC. Again here also use BPT by BPT. What is BPT? Basic proportionality theorem. So again using BPT, here we will get AD by DB equal to AE by EC. Substitute the values. AD we don't know, keep like that only. And DB is 7.2 is equal to AE, that is 1.8 divided by 5.4. Okay, so again here also do the cross multiplication, take 7.2 to the right side. Here we will get AD equal to 1.8 into 7.2 whole divided by 5.4. Keenly observe here, in 1.8 we are getting decimal point after one number, 5.4 also we are getting decimal after one number. So it is easy to divide them. 1.8, see, it is taken as a 18, 18 ones are 18 threes also. Okay, so ignoring the decimal on both sides, so here it becomes 18 and it becomes 54. 18 ones are 18 threes are. So 18 ones are 18 threes are. Now remaining 7.2 divided by 3. So divide it by 3. 3 ones are 3, 2s are 6. 1 is remaining, it becomes 12. So 4s are 3, 4s are. We'll get 12. So our AD equal to 2.4 cm. In second question, they given here E and F on the point PQ and PR in triangle ABC. For each of the following case, state whether EF is parallel to QR. EF is parallel to QR. When we can say EF is parallel to QR? When the sides ratio are equal to each other. It is converse of BPT, basic proportionality theorem. So if you get these sides ratio are equal, then you can say that EF is parallel to QR. Let's see the first question. The given PE by QE or EQ. Let's see, first take PE by, it is in first case, PE by EQ equal to PF by FR. Substitute the values. Okay, if you get the same ratio, then you can say EF is parallel to QR. Let's see here. PE, how much they given? 3.9 divided by EQ is 3 is equal to PF is 3.6 cm divided by 2.4. Okay, so first I will divide this side, left side, 3 ones are 3 ones are 3, 3 threes are. So here we got 1.3. Let's see this side. 3.6, 2.4. Just ignore one decimal point, on both sides one decimal point is there. So it becomes 36 and it becomes 24 by ignoring the decimal. So 36 and 24 are in the 12th table. So 12 threes are 12 twos are. Again, if you divide this, 2 ones are 2, 1.5 are. So here we are getting 1.5, which is not equal to 1.3. So that's why the given condition is not satisfy our converse of BPT. That's why in first case EF is not parallel to QR. Okay, this is our first case. Now again in second case PET given how much? 4 cm. Instead of EQ, they given TV. Both are same. That is 4.5 cm equal to PF is 8 cm and FR is 9 cm. Okay, see here 4 and 4.5. Here 8 and 9. Just see the 4, 2's are 8. 4.5, 2's are 9. It means it is a multiple of 2. So better way, divide this term by 2. So 2, 4's are 2, 4.5's are. So here we are getting 4 by 4.5 equal to 4 by 4.5, where it satisfies the converse of BPT. Because the size ratio is equal, then automatically you can say EF is parallel to QR. We are writing. Therefore, PEF is parallel to QR. This is our second condition. Now in third condition, they given PQ, that is 1.28, PR they given, that is 2.56, PE they given 0.18, PF they given 0.36. But for size ratio, similar ratio, what we need PE by EQ and PF by FR. See, in the given points, we are not getting EQ and we are not getting FR. For that, what we have to do? Simple thing. See here, EQ. Where is EQ? EQ is here. In total PQ, if you remove PE, we will get EQ. So instead of writing here EQ, I will write PE divided by EQ. Instead of EQ, I will write PQ minus PE. Again, here also, PF is there. So instead of FR, I will write PR minus PR minus FR. PR minus F. Sorry, PF. PR minus PF. So what is PE? PE is the given 0.18 divided by PQ. Where is PQ? That is 1.28 minus what is PE? PE is 0.18 equal to what is PF? PF is 0.36 divided by PR minus PF. Where is PR? PR is here. 2.56 minus PF, that is 0.36. Okay, so now 0.18 divided by, now if you will make subtraction, here you will get 1.10 equal to, here if you make subtraction, here you will get 0.36 divided by 2.20. Again, recall the second case, how you did? Here, just ignore the decimal, it is 18. So let's take it as 10. So 18, 2 is 36, we get it, the multiple of 2. And here also 1.1 is multiple, gives you, multiple of 2 gives you 2.20. So better way, divide this, the second term by 2. Here you will get 0.18 and here also you will get 1.10. So here you got 0.18 divided by 1.10. So it satisfies the size ratio. That's why EF is parallel to QR. So right here, therefore, EF is parallel to QR. We can, in bracket, you can write converse of BPT also. The third question, they given on diagram. Along with that, they given LM is parallel to CB. LM is parallel to CB. And LN, that is LN is parallel to CD. We have to prove that AM by AB equal to AN by AD. So let's take first, I'll consider A, B, C. In triangle, in proof, I'll consider the first part, that is A, B, C. In triangle, A, B, C. Okay, what are the parallel lines? LM or ML. LM parallel to CB or BC. Okay, so by basic proportionality theorem or by BPT, what we get? We get here AM by MB equal to AL by LC. We'll get size ratio. Similarly, in triangle here, ACD, triangle ACD, LN are similar to CD. So in triangle ACD, what they given? LN is parallel to CD. LN is parallel to CD. Again now by BPT, we will get here AL by LC equal to AN by ND. Okay, so let's take the first ratio as our equation number 1 and equation number 2. See then, from equation number 1 and equation number 2, what are the similarities? Here, AL is AL by LC. Here also AL by LC. So, by equation number 1 and 2, the common thing is AL by LC. Just you remove. So, what you will get? AM by MB from 1 and 2. From 1 and 2, we will get here AM by MB equal to AN by ND. Okay, so it's not completed, still is there. Why? See here, AM by MB we need, we are getting, but here we need AM by AB. Okay, so now recalling your example number 1. So to getting that AB, that is whole side, what we have to do? Just to reciprocal this, okay, reciprocal this to sides ratio and afterwards add one on both sides. So now reciprocaling this to, so here we will get MB by AM equal to ND by AN. Okay, so adding one on both sides, here we will get MB by AM plus 1 equal to ND by AN plus 1. Okay, so taking the LCM, here we will get MB plus AM by 1 AM equal to nd plus an divided by an. Okay, so mb plus am, see the figure, mb plus am, what we will get? Total ab divided by am equal to nd plus an, see there, nd plus an. So if you add these two, you will get here ad. So it becomes ad by an. Okay, so again you repeat the reciprocally. So here we get am by ab equal to an by ad. This is our required side ratio. See here, am by ab, an by nd, ad. Fourth question, it is also similar to the third question. Just you should know where the parallel sides are there in a triangle. So take those triangles separately and use the BPD theorem. So you will get the sides ratio. Afterwards, you have to equalize the equations. First one, DE is parallel to AC. See here, where is DE? DE is parallel to AC. Okay, first we take the triangle ABC. If you want, you can redraw, or else directly you can proceed from the sides ratio. Let's see in triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, I am taking the whole triangle. In that, what is there? DE is parallel to AC. DE is parallel to AC. So just you ignore these two lines. That is DF and AC, AE. Just ignore them. Only you have to see DE is parallel to AC. So by BPT, okay, BD by DA is equal to BE by AC. So let's take as equation number 1. Similarly, now taking the second given point, that is DF parallel to AE. Where is DF? DF is here. It is parallel to what? AE. So just now ignore the AC part. Okay. So now taking triangle ABE. So now taking triangle ABE. ABE. What are the parallel lines? DF parallel to AE. Okay. So if DF is parallel to AE, then what about the BPD? That is BD by BPD by BPT, that is basic proportionality theorem. It is always repeating in this first exercise. So BD, that is divides by DA equal to here DF by FC. Sorry, FE divides by FE. So let's take it as equation number 2. From 1 and 2, what are the similar things? Here also BD by DA. Here also BD by DA. So equating equation number 1 and 2. So from 1 and 2, we get here BE by AC, or else you first write you can BF by FE, this one equal to BE by AC. Okay, what we need in the proof? Okay, BF by FE, BE by AC. Same thing we got. And it is true. Now in fifth question, they given one triangle along with few intersecting lines DE is parallel to OQ and DF is parallel to OR. We have to show that this EF is parallel to QR. So from last question, what we got there, we have to show that the size ratio. But here we have to show that sides are in parallel. So here we have to use converse of BPT. Yes, converse of BPT you have to use here. So first we should know where the size ratio we will get. First one, DE is parallel to OQ. Where is that? DE is parallel to OQ. So let's take triangle PQO. So in triangle PQO. Okay, in triangle PQO, what are they given? They given DE is parallel to OQ. So if DE is parallel to OQ by BPT, what we will get? So by BPT we will get here PE by EQ is equal to PD by DU. Let's take it as equation number 1. Similarly, another one given point is given. What is that? DF is parallel to OR. Where is DF? DF is here. DF is parallel to OR. Let's take this triangle. It is POR. Or else PRO. So again, in triangle PRO, what are the parallel lines? DF is parallel to OR. Okay, DF is parallel to OR, then again using BPT, what you got? By BPT what you get? APD by DO, PD by DO equal to PF by FR. So let's take it as equation number 2. See, from equation number 1 and 2, what are you getting the similarity? See here, PD by DO, here also PD by DO. So, from 1 and 2, we get PE by EQ is equal to PF by FR. So we got size ratio in triangle, which triangle? Triangle PQR. So if we get the equal size ratio, then we can say that the midline, that is EF, is parallel to QR by using converse of BPT. So here I write by converse of BPT in triangle PQR will get EF parallel to QR. So by converse of BPT we can write in triangle PQR EF is parallel to QR because we get in the sides ratio.